What is going on, guys? Welcome back to another video. So today we're going to be trying to work on the RestoGen's 3200 RPM governor spring.
What I'm actually going to do is start that first shit up and bring it over closer to the actual barn. That way we can be a little bit closer to the tools, just because I'm not exactly sure if we're going to be able to get this finished today or not. Just kind of depends if I have all the proper tools. I know it doesn't take that many things to get these pumps off. There's only a few things really, but you never know. Crazier things have happened. Beautiful. Figured I would get started on the 3200 governor spring swap so that I could get some leeway on that and get that going. And of course, everything was going smooth. Everything's going, oh, fun, you know, upgrades, good time, whatever. You know how that goes. My chickens are going berserk. So hopefully you can hear me okay. I was in the process of swapping this and I had to remove some things. I removed some of the throttle assembly. I removed a banjo bolt. I removed three of the Allen style small screws slash bolts holding down the top half of the VE pump. I even removed a part of the throttle adjustment stuff, throttle adjustment screw. One more of these on the back side of the pump, and that's what's causing this whole freaking mess right now of not being able to get the freaking thing out. Basically one of these Allen screws, right? And it's down in the back of the pump, right? There's one left that's just in a really stupid spot. You can't get to it unless you have either a super long Allen with a ball end on it, or you basically have to remove the throttle adjustment screw that kind of sits. There's two of them, one in the front, one on the back of the pump. I'll show you the screw in a second. And essentially though, this is down in here. I'm just gonna set this up on its end, even though imagine the head that you're supposed to unthread the Allen with on this side. It's the only way it'll set up on this. They have it setting like this. Okay, to where you can almost but not quite get your Allen in there. Therefore, you either have to A, have a small ball head Allen style to go down in and get it, or B, you have to back this whole screw out. That way you can actually take that out. The problem is backing this out is a pain in the butt because, let me show you, it's a pain in the butt because you really can't get to it unless you remove all of this stuff. And it's just, yeah. These trucks are great because they're so easy to work on, but they can still give you those frustrating moments. Don't let them fool you into thinking that there's nothing frustrating about it. None of this stuff is really that hard, but it's just one of those things where when you don't want to have to undo everything else just to get one little thing out, just kind of annoying. I'm going to leave the truck right here where it sits, just close the hood so nothing gets in there. We're gonna have to pick back up on this process probably tomorrow. We're gonna go get to some hunting and we will catch you back over here tomorrow. There's definitely time to get these things washed down.
So I've actually been daily driving this truck pretty much like every day since I've gotten it. Running around so much that forget to wash it sometimes. So we're gonna get this thing all nice and washed down today.
Do you a little bit of a before. Oh man, that ain't good.
Feel the dust. You can definitely see the dust on the side. It almost looks like charcoal gray. Look at that, gross.
Get this thing cleaned up. Now we're not done with this, but I thought I would show you this little before and after shot. This is the front half. There's still some soap on it because we're not done, but clean, not clean yet. Much better. Check it out. So this thing's all cleaned up, looks a lot better, but now we've got to clean the Whistling Diesel first gen because it's getting picked up today to get sent out to Utah. One good looking first gen. Holy smokes. You enjoy the heck out of this thing, Austin. It's one heck of a truck. Another day has gone by for this video segment. We did get the trucks cleaned up though. First gen is gone and shipped out. Headed to Austin in Utah. We got this thing all cleaned up. The suspension and everything looks so much better. If you guys want to enter to win this truck, you guys literally have like less than 48 hours left to enter to win this thing. Then it's gone. So if you haven't gotten entered to win, every $1 you spend is 10 entries towards winning this truck plus $5,000 cash. To go drop off some more orders. The wife took the Cadillac today, so I couldn't take all the orders at one time that we got packed yesterday, but hundreds just alone in the back seat here, because a lot of them are t-shirts and stuff, so they don't take up a lot of room. But we're gonna go drop these off. We're gonna go to pick up a set of tools to finish the first gen. We're gonna go pick up a couple tree stands for Reagan and I's new property we bought. I don't know how many of you guys heard about that. We got the one property over in Ohio, and then like a month later, actually not even, like 2 weeks after we closed on it, essentially, another property came up for sale, like a really, really great deal right next to the in-laws, you know, her parents. It was like right next door, and it was like super good price and good location. And I'm like, okay, I know we just bought a property, Reagan, but we've got to buy this one too. Like, it was just too good of a deal, and the location was in a spot where I know we would use it a lot throughout the year. So I thought, you know what? I'm okay with the hour and 20 minute drive, because we'll be able to use it all the time when we're down there. It's not like we're going out of our way. It's right next to some place where we're gonna be a lot. So it makes sense if you're gonna do it in a location that's a little bit further from home. As long as it's next to a place you're gonna visit a lot and it's not out of your way, it's not a bad deal. So we're excited about that. We're supposed to close on that tomorrow. I'm mostly focused on the first gen though for today's video. Maybe I'll show you the tree stand stuff, I don't know, but I'm more focused on getting the proper tool to finish the pump on that first gen. Hoping this is gonna do it. Fits down in there. I think it's catching. Let's see if I can grab it. I think we got it. I think that broke it loose. Yeah, you can see all the fuel leaking down now. I'm out of my shop because I knew that this was gonna happen. But if you're gonna be working in your shop and you don't want diesel everywhere, you know, of course you can put something under there to absorb it.
Man, that ballpoint Allen head. Thing works wonders.
Tap this to break it loose. So here's what it's gonna look like underneath here. Now I'm gonna need a set of needle nose pliers and my other spring for the next step. And it should just pop off pretty easy there. That's off right there. It's easiest if you have your 3200 governor spring in hand ready. So when you pop this other one off, you can just swap it out real quick. I put a new O-ring right here. This little black piece right here, there was an old green one on there. The pump is newer, but I don't know if that was swapped out or not. I'm guessing it was, but it came with a new one, so I just put the new one on.
You should just be able to hook this on here real easy. Just don't drop anything in your pump.
So what I actually ended up doing right here is I backed a smoke screw out. It's connected with some kind of locking gel or Loctite something or another, with this nut locking it to the actual screw itself up there. That way it stays in the same spot. Once I thread it back in, it'll stop in the same spot that it was.
but I had to back it out because it was getting in the way of this lever and it wouldn't sit down on the pump right because this lever has to be pushed forward just a little bit. Can't really push it forward with all this stuff in the way over here and set it down on. So I'm just backing that out. I'm gonna set it down on, and then once I get the four Allen screws back in the pump, then I'm gonna just thread this back into where it was set stock, so that way at least for now it's not tampered with. But that way we don't like put the four on there and then it's like resting on top of this lever here and then we like tighten it down and freaking crack the thing, or the pump doesn't work right, or just something bad. So that's all I'm gonna do for now, and then we're gonna get on to reinstallation of the pump. I believe we are done. Everything is reassembled properly. Everything's fastened back in. I got my two lines that were running to the pump threaded back in with the banjo bolts. I believe I got the throttle indexing put back in correctly. Try to look through some forms and stuff and make sure I didn't do anything wrong. But you know, anything can happen. And these VE pumps are kind of sensitive. So I'm gonna actually take my intake side off. Everything I put back in, I put it back in to factory. My threading for my idle adjustment, my power screw, everything is put back to where it was factory. The closest I thought it was. The power screw had like this green, super hard locking stuff on it. I don't know what that stuff is for, but it locks it in place pretty well. It had the nut on that, the locking nut actually locked onto the power screw itself so it didn't move. And so I just backed it out with the 6mm at the very, very end, the small end of that power screw. I just backed it out and put it right back into exactly where it was. At least that's the hopes, because I didn't move it in any other way. But you never know. So I'm going to actually take my intake off on this side, and I'm hoping nothing crazy happens, just in case it could run away. But you just never know. You know, I'd rather be safe than sorry. So we're going to be ready for that possibility and take the intake off and then try to start it up and then try to rev it a few times and just kind of see what happens. Now I've got my board cut. Make sure your board is flush. The reason is because if you have like a super bowed piece of wood and it doesn't cover this up all the way, there's a good chance it's not going to shut the truck off. It still might, but there's a good chance that it won't, and you'll still just have the problem and you won't be prepared. So I cut this board.
I mean, when I put it in there, there's zero cracks or crevices around that thing, so
that should be good. Let's give her a start. I'm a little bit nervous. I'm not even gonna lie to you guys, I'm kind of like super nervous. I've watched all the runaway videos. None of them end very well. And even if they do end okay, still isn't any less terrifying. That is exactly what I didn't want to happen. Oh, that's terrifying. But I got the right board. Oh my goodness. I don't even know what happened.
I'm kind of at a loss for words right now. I've been trying to do some research on my phone, trying to figure out what could have happened during my reinstallation of that top half of the VE pump, because I didn't turn the fuel screw up and I left it where it was factory. I'm even looking at the green colored stuff that they put on the threadings and the nut. The nut is literally like seized to the fuel screw itself, so it can't move, which is a good thing. I didn't want it to move from stock yet, because I wanted to just make sure I got everything put back together and I could compare, you know, the fuel pin to the fuel pin with the governor spring, and then with the fuel pin, governor spring, and turning up the fuel, and then on top of that, then doing the injectors and trying to compare everything, you know, one thing at a time. I don't know what went wrong, but I could definitely use some help in the comments if there's anybody out there that's dealt with these things. All I did was backed it out on the very, very end, on that 6mm end of that power screw. I just backed it straight out. I didn't move the nut on it at all, so it went right back into the same spot, and I tightened it right back in. That's all I did. It's kind of hard to say. Is that the only thing that can cause it, or no? And that's what I'm trying to figure out. So if there's something else that could have caused that, what could it have been? And I'm gonna have to do some more research over the next day and try to figure out exactly what it is before I go messing with this again, because I'd rather tear the pump apart again and take that hour to tear it apart again and just double check and triple check everything again and put it all back together than just do it right now while I'm out here by myself and not thoroughly doing research first. Then I'm just looking blindly, looking all over the place, trying to figure out what it was when I don't really know what it was yet. You know what I'm saying? So that's what I'm gonna try to do. If anybody has some helpful tips or pointers or links to any forums that explain what else could be the cause of the runaway, that'd be awesome to make sure that I'm not missing anything. If it's only the power screw, then we'll just have to tinker around with that a little bit more. Maybe I can see if I can try to find, you know, some available time with somebody that knows how to work around these things and they can be quick, just in case we gotta stop that again and keep messing with it for a couple hours. But we're gonna get it sorted out. I just, right here by myself, it's kind of a little bit sketchy because if I don't get over here in time, that's not good. That's gonna be the end of this segment working on the rest of Gen. Let me go show you that dually up front.
Well, here's the third Gen. Last 48 hours to enter to win the truck. Every $1, 10 entries. Every order gets cash. Every order ships. If you want to enter to win it, it ends on November 11th. So you are running out of time.